Hello and welcome to another informative tutorial for the next generation vectorizer, the ContourTrace software. In this video, we'll show you how to create a shadow board using ContourTrace in under 10 minutes, following a few simple steps. We will use the Area Scan Portal automatic operation with the ContourTrace for this demonstration to scan objects. First, we need to place and arrange the tools that we are trying to create the shadow board on a position marker template. Next, open the Image Stitching with Position Markers module in the ContourTrace application. In the Input Selection menu, you'll find four different input options for scanning objects within this module. If you select Video as the input, you'll need to import a pre-recorded video of the objects placed on the position marker template. Regardless of the input method, it's important to use the same position marker template that was used during object scanning. You can confirm this by checking the template ID, located at the bottom left corner of the template. Once selected, click the Generate Image button to start the image stitching process. If you select Camera as an input option, choose one of the detected cameras or smartphones and begin the image stitching process. As you scan the objects placed on the position marker template, the images are stitched in real time. You can also choose Area Scan Portal, Manual Operation as the input. Once selected, the corresponding Area Scan Portal camera will be automatically assigned. Then, begin the image stitching process while manually moving the camera within the portal as the images are stitched. Now, we'll proceed with Area Scan Portal, Automatic Operation as the input selection. With this option, the objects will be scanned automatically. Without further delay, let's begin the image stitching process. Once the generation process begins, on the right side you will observe real-time camera movements within the Area Scan Portal. Meanwhile, the left side window will display real-time image stitching of the orthogonal view of the objects as they are being processed. As you can see, in the first step the camera moves in a zigzag pattern to get an overview image. In the subsequent precise scanning, the camera automatically moves along the contours of the objects to get a precise orthogonal view of that object. For objects with significant height, multiple precise scans may be required. In such cases, you can start the image stitching process with a scan repetition of 2 or 3. Alternatively, if the image has already been stitched, you can perform an additional precision scan by starting another stitching process and selecting Run a precision scan on the image instead of Start new scan. Once the image generation process is done, save the generated image for further contour extraction process in ContourTrace. Now we'll load the stitched image into ContourTrace and start extracting the contours. In the drawing operator, we'll make some adjustments to refine the contours. Next, we'll provide an offset for the contours. But before that, it's crucial to set the scale factor correctly to ensure that the exported contours maintain accurate real-world dimensions. The correct scale factor for this stitched image can be obtained from the ISPM module. Alternatively, you can set the scale factor by measuring two points on the stitched image, preferably with a significant distance apart, and set the actual real-world distance to recalculate the scale factor. To make it easier to pick up the tools, we will now create recessed handles for this shadow board. Next, we will export the contour as a DXF file. This DXF file can then be used for manufacturing, whether for laser cutting or designing a 3D model in a CAD software, which can later be milled into a shadow board. That concludes this tutorial. To explore more features of ContourTrace and learn how to use the Area Scan Portal, watch the other videos, visit our website at ContourTrace.com or contact us directly to find out more about ContourTrace.